Welcome to Subramani. This is not exactly a disclaimer, but I wish to clarify certain things. When there is a huge disadvantage also when you read a lot, especially on finance. So nothing that I say is going to be sounds original to me, nor will it sound very original to people who have read a lot, because everything has been said. I don't see what new I can say in personal finance. I mean, go right up from JP Morgan, or if you want to go 250 years, go to Benjamin Franklin. All of them have said more or less similar things, which means earn well. If you're not earning well, go and renegotiate with your boss. Try to increase your income. Do a side gig. Pay your taxes honestly. Do some charity. Whatever is left, invest it regularly and live with financial integrity. So what are the steps which are necessary to get wealthy? Make sure that you and your family are in sync with each other. Get a financial mentor if you need to. Very strongly believe that equities will, there will be reversion to mean. So during bad periods, you need that faith that the markets will come back. You have to have faith that a portfolio will come back, but a single share may just go down and remain there. Silverline is a case in point. Went from 10, 20, 30 to 1,300, then came down to 6 and it stayed at 6 or below 6. Doesn't matter. But that will never happen with a portfolio, because a portfolio will go up and go down depending on what's happening in the market. But even after, if a equity portfolio like a Sensex or Nifty falls 30, 40, 50%, the biggest I have seen is 45% in 1993, the market will come back. Remember that. As long as you believe in that, if you buy more units when the markets are bad, it's great for you. If you can't buy, don't despair. If there are times when you can't invest, don't despair. Okay, it's nice to create wealth, but during some periods you may not be able to create wealth. That should not worry you. You're creating wealth for a very long period, so it is intergenerational. Chances are you may not enjoy all the benefits of what you've done today. Imagine the 70-year-old who's planting a tree. He's sure that he's not going to enjoy all the fruits from that tree. Even if he lives till the age of 100, he may enjoy, but the tree is going to live far beyond him. He does not go and cut the tree. When Ghanshyam Das Birla was setting up Hindalco, I'm sure he didn't know whether he would be alive to see the plant work. His son came into it, more I would say his grandson Aditya came into it, and after that now it is his son Kumar Mangalam Birla who is handling it, and three generations later that plant will still be there. The man who planted the tree may not be there, but the mangoes will be there, right? So remember that the wealth creation process is simple. So it is not something new which I can say. I don't think there are more than 150 words to be said about the wealth creation process. Yes, there's a lot of stuff that you can do, value investing and this and that. But ultimately, if you don't want to get into any of those stuff, then just keep it very simple. One of the simplest things you can do is make sure that you have lesser number of things you have. So declutter everything, including your portfolio, declutter your wardrobe, declutter the table in which you're sitting and working, and have the following items. Have one savings bank account, maybe two, not more than that. Have one term insurance for whatever amount that you need. If you think you need, there'll be two beneficiaries. Let's say you're a 30-year-old, you're married, and you want your wife to have a policy. That's great. Make your wife a nominee. But if you think you're parents will find it difficult to ask your wife for money in case you are not there, then take another policy with your mother and father as the beneficiary, right? So these are simple things. So take a term insurance. Make sure that your health insurance is adequate, right? So adequacy you have to define. Understand what is health insurance and what is top up, what is super top up. Buy accordingly. Don't have to buy everything, but make sure that you're taking a very sensible action. Have a wealth plan apart from a financial plan. Make sure that your family knows about the wealth plan. Commit to it together. Your youngest kid can monitor the plan for the family. Don't tell me it's a great thing. Teaching your family about money is a fantastic thing to do, because it will force you to educate yourself. Because your son or daughter may ask, Dad, why do you want to put money in equity? You've got only 3% return in the last 5 years. whereas you are getting 8% return in PPF or 7% return in PPF, right? So you will have to answer those questions, which will force you to learn. So learn, increase the financial education, financial IQ of the whole family, not just yourself. Now imagine the 13-year-old whom you are teaching all this. What amazing wealth that kid is going to create in its lifetime. So right, so make a will. Get, when you get financially educated, you will do all this. So just do these things. These are very simple. On my blog and on my YouTube videos, you will find ideas which are dull and boring and repetitive. But you have got to do these dull and boring and repetitive things for good health. Like getting up in the morning and going for a walk, or getting up in the morning going for a run, or eating dal chawal instead of eating complex food and complicating the your stomach and brain not knowing how to process it, right? So keep things simple. It can be kept simple. Improve your financial IQ. Whatever feedback, happy to take. Thank you.